गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस द कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स ऑफ द स्टीम पावर प्लांट. वी हैव डिस्कस ऑल द सिक्स पैरामीटर्स व्हिच आर द मेन कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स ऑफ अ टिपिकल थर्मल प्लांट एंड वी हैव डिस्कस द वर्किंग ऑफ थर्मल पावर प्लांट ऑल्सो. वी हैव कवर्ड ऑल द सिक्स पैरामीटर्स which is the most important blocks, fundamental blocks of the steam power plant. We have discussed that in detail along with the diagram, along with the whole thing. Now the topic for today's class is choice of site selection for steam power station. It is as simple as that. We have discussed it earlier also, but we are discussing it again in detail, that what are the criterias for the steam power station site selection. Site means location. So what are the parameters which we need to consider while selecting a steam power plant? You know, it is a big process. ये ऐसा नहीं होता है कि आपने सोच लिया गवर्नमेंट ने और कहीं पे भी जाके पावर प्लांट लगा लिया. नहीं, इट इज कभी भी कोई भी चीज अगर कंसेप्शन में लानी होती है, कोई इंस्टॉलेशन लगाना होता है, तो पूरी टीम बैठती है, पूरे बोर्ड बैठते हैं, पूरे बोर्ड मेंबर्स डिसाइड करते हैं कि व्हाट इज द लोड ऑफ दैट एरिया एंड व्हाट इज द लोड गोइंग टू बी इन नेक्स्ट 30-40 years, 50 years, प्रोबेबली 60 years. व्हाट कुड बी द लोड, व्हाट इज द पॉपुलेशन डेंसिटी, व्हाट आर द एग्जिस्टिंग इंस्टॉलेशन कैपेसिटी ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर स्टेट एंड हाउ मच लोड इज इंक्रीज्ड. And suppose a power plant is there. We know that most of the time new colonies are built up, new factories are built up, new colleges are built up in the different areas. So the electricity requirement will also be increased, right? So they need to take all the. For example, अगर हमारे यहाँ investors आते हैं, जैसे अगर आप देखते होंगे कि MP में कई बार होता है एक special economic zone है जो इंदौर में बनाया हुआ है, right? तो जब ये business summit होती है chief minister के साथ में, ये पूरा SEZ मतलब एक स्पेशल इकोनॉमिक जोन दिया जहाँ पे वो इंडस्ट्रीज को, कॉर्पोरेट ऑफिसर्स को, एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट्स को या कुछ फैक्ट्रीज को, ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस को वो लीज आउट करते हैं, ठीक है ना? तो वो एक पर्टिकुलर जोन उनको देते हैं. जब जोन देते हैं तो उसके अकॉर्डिंगली पूरा प्लान करना पड़ता है ना, कि उसमें वहां पे फिर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फैसिलिटी भी देनी पड़ेगी, वहां पे फिर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन फैसिलिटी भी देनी पड़ेगी, यू विल हैव टू गिव द इलेक्ट्रिकल कनेक्शंस आल्सो. सो व्हेन द इलेक्ट्रिकल पीपल सेट टुगेदर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू इंस्टॉल अ पावर स्टेशन एंड विच काइंड ऑफ पावर स्टेशन वी नीड टू इंस्टॉल by for fulfilling the existing or the upcoming demands of electricity, so they sit together, they analyze on the things, they brainstorming about the all the factors, data, and they foresize it for 50 years, for coming years also, because aaj power plant lagana hai to aaj ka to dekhna nahi ki aaj laga diya ho gaya, you know, they foresee the future of it also. That how much amount we'll be producing, how much electricity we'll be, and how much electricity if the extension is required. So suppose they have installed one unit, and if suppose the in future the demand has been increased according to the one or the other factors, then what they'll do? They can also plan for another unit for the same. For example, thermal power plant, one unit is working and they are installing or starting the other unit also. So they need to decide it according to the circumstances, but they need to think today only. I mean, in the current scenario also, if they'll be requiring the another unit to be installed after suppose 10-20 years, so that the place should contain that surplus amount of area also, surplus amount of facilities also for availing for installing the second unit also. So these are the things. So the choice of site selection is very important in all the power stations. So we have a few points, around 6 points we are having. The 6 major points are there which needs to be considered while keeping the location selection for the steam power station. So in order to achieve the overall economy, the following points should be considered while selecting a site for the steam power station. Number one is supply of fuel, because this is the foremost most important point, because the fuel is the majority ingredient which is used to produce the electricity, right? So supply of fuel is very important. We have mostly things we have discussed already, but we'll be taking it step by step so that you can be writing it while in your exam. If they ask about these questions, you have something to write also. So I have arranged these slides as point wise, so that you can have the written material also, and you can prepare notes by taking help from these slides. So the supply of fuel categorized for the following points. The steam power station should be located near the coal mine so that the transportation cost of fuel is minimum. As we have discussed in last class also, that 50% of thermal power plant cost is because of the fuel, maintenance of fuel, handling of fuel, cost of fuel, transportation of fuel. This makes the 50% cost of a thermal power plant, right? So the cost of fuel is the majority part, and so many research papers are there for wheeling charges are known as the, when you will be come to the research point of view, wheeling charges is the term which is used, wheel, because the electric wagon travels on wheels, right? If you will be talking about the road transportation, that is also the trucks or the carriage wagon also have wheels. So this is categorized as wheeling charges. So this is a major area of research in which these things are considered. So the transportation cost of fuel should be minimum. You have to, select a location where coal mines are near, so that transportation of fuel cost can be reduced. And however, if such plant is to be installed at a place where coal is not available, the care should be taken that adequate facilities exist for the coal of transportation of coal. If suppose coal mines are not nearer, but there should be provision of transporting the coal, either it by road or by rail, but whichever be suitable, but that should be considered. Next point is availability of water. As we know that the working of power plant needs a large amount of water, so that water could be heated to form the steam, then steam again get condensed, and cooling tower needs water, lots of water. We should have the river or canal or water bodies near it, so that the rotation of steam should be properly managed. So the huge amount of water is required for the condenser. Therefore, such a plant should be located at the bank of a river, preferably, or near a canal to ensure the continuous supply of water. This is the main thing. The availability of water is a key factor, is a majority factor again after fuel. And the third is the transportation facilities. As we were discussing, a modern steam power station often requires the transportation of machines and material also, because as far as our knowledge is concerned, thermal power plant maintenance is highest among the all power plants, almost highest in all the power plants. So lots of machineries are involved. You have seen in the schematic diagram, and working of the air preheater is there, economizer is there, forced rod fan are there, and induced rod fans are there, cooling towers are there, pumps are there, turbines are there, alternators are there, circuit breaker, transformers, bus bars, and coal handling arrangement, ash handling arrangement, boiler assemblies, so many things are there. So it requires the proper transportation of material and machinery also, because it wear and tear happens, and you need to have the material and machinery again and again, or you can need the maintenance facility also. So the transportation should be taken care, and therefore adequate transportation facilities must exist. That means the plant should be well connected to the other parts of countries by rail and road. This is the main thing. Then next comes the cost and type of land. This is very important. You cannot build a steam power plant in an agricultural land. Why? Because of agricultural land produces lots of grains, so its cost is also high. The more fertile is the land, the more costly it would be. So if a government is government wants to install a hydro power plant, then they need the size of hundreds of acres. Villages needs to be rehabilitated, to be shifted to another place. So the lots of initial cost is required there, lots of land cost is required there. So as far as cost and type of land is concerned, the steam power station should be located at a place where land is cheap, because we need not to have the agricultural land, we just have to install that the assembly there. So, and further extension if necessary, if possible, I was talking about that. The point has been considered here. If further extension possible, if necessary, the further extension possible, that is what I was talking about. If for the current requirement, we have one unit, and in next few years, next 15, 20 years, the electricity requirement if increase, then we need to install another unit also. So we are selecting a place, we need to see whether there is a chance of further extension or not. So the steam power station should be located at a place where land is cheap and further extension if necessary is possible. And next thing is, moreover, the bearing capacity of ground should be more adequate so that the heavy equipment should be installed. The ground soil quality should be like that it could bear the heavy equipment weight, and the equipment should be installed properly. You know that the type of land should be like that only, because हमको देखना पड़ेगा कि बहुत भुरभुरी जमीन है क्या या बहुत soft है क्या place, काली मिट्टी है कि लाल मिट्टी है, बजरी वाली है, रेतीली जमीन है, या फिर हमको ये देखना पड़ेगा पठार है क्या, वहां पे चट्टाने हैं क्या. तो कितने आपने पढ़ा होगा, बहुत सारे टाइप ऑफ सॉइल, टाइप ऑफ लैंड आपने पढ़ा है. तो वो दैट वी नीड टू टेक अंडर द कंसिडरेशन दैट विच टाइप ऑफ लैंड इज देयर, एंड लैंड शुड बी लाइक दैट सो दैट इट कुड सपोर्ट दी हैवी मशीनरी. बिकॉज बहुत मैंने आपको टर्बाइन दिखाया था लास्ट क्लास में, साइज ऑफ टर्बाइन यू हैव सीन, एंड यू हैव सीन दी यू नो यू हैव सीन दी size of size of boiler also, size of turbine also. So heavy machinery is involved in that. So it should be considered. Moreover, the bearing capacity of ground is it should be chosen like that. Then the next is nearness to the load center. This is again a very important point, that the amount of electricity you are being utilized, you are being produced, that needs to be transported also. So the load center, where the load center is there, where we need to connect that or we need to put the generated electricity in that. So the nearness to the load center should be also be considered, because the transmission cost is very high. Anybody have any idea that how much the transmission line cost? For example, if I want to, मैंने अभी यहाँ पे एक सोलर पार्क प्लांट लगाया और मुझे एक किलोमीटर दूर में मेरा लोड सेंटर है, मुझे वहां पे कनेक्ट करना है, तो एक किलोमीटर दूर के तक मुझे ट्रांसमिशन लाइन लगेगी. डू यू हैव एनी आइडिया एक किलोमीटर ट्रांसमिशन लाइन बिछाने में कितनी कॉस्ट आती होगी? कोई भी रफ आइडिया, कोई भी बताओ आप में से, एनीबडी ऑफ यू, एक रफ आइडिया, एनीबडी? नो आइडिया. ओके, it needs around 4 to 5 lakhs to install a 1 kilometer transmission line. Agar aap 3 phase power install kar rahe hain, 3 phase power kahin se generate kar rahe hain, DGs ke through distributed generation, jisko hum bolte hain wind se, ya solar se hum agar distribution end pe power generate kar rahe hain, to mujhe load center tak jana padega, right? To wo load center agar 1 kilometer dur hai, 1 kilometer transmission line install karne ke liye हमको 4 to 5 lakh रुपीस का इन्वेस्टमेंट आता है. तो आप यू कैन सी कि ट्रांसमिशन लाइन से नियरनेस कितना इम्पोर्टेंट है. अगर सपोज 10 किलोमीटर दूर जाना है तो आपके 40-50 lakhs तो अप्रोक्सीमेटली लग गए, राइट? फॉर अवेलिंग दिस इलेक्ट्रिसिटी प्रोडक्शन इज अनदर थिंग, बट यू हैव टू ट्रांसपोर्ट दैट ऑल्सो. द ट्रांसमिशन पार्ट इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द नियरनेस टू द रोड सेंटर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई वॉज एक्सप्लेनिंग द फर्स्ट पॉइंट, इन ऑर्डर टू रिड्यूस द ट्रांसमिशन कॉस्ट, द प्लांट शुड बी लोकेटेड नियर द सेंटर ऑफ लोड. दिस इज पर्टिकुलरली इंपॉर्टेंट इफ डीसी सप्लाई सिस्टम इज अडॉप्टेड. इन डीसी सप्लाई इट इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट, because you need to if AC, most of the transmission is AC in India, and DC supply is also there, and HVDC is there. You will be studying that subject later in your higher semesters. So the DC supply system is more costlier, right, as compared to the AC system. So if AC supply system is adopted, this factor become relatively less important, because the cost can be kept, because of so many lots of web of transmission lines are there already. So installing few kilometers, you can see a point where you can feed in your feeder can be set, where you can feed in your electricity produced by your power station. But in DC system, this is quite difficult because in DC, the most of the DC lines are not there. HVDC line separately needs to be installed other than the AC. Then you need to have the more cost is involved in that. And it is because why so? Because the AC power can be transmitted at high voltages with the consequent reduced transmission cost. Now DC transmission cost is high as compared to the AC transmission cost. Therefore, it is possible to install the plant away from the load center, provided that the condition is favorable. It could be installed away from the load center, but the nearness should be kept under consideration as far as the cost factors are, expenses are concerned. And the last point for the choice selection of a typical steam power plant is the distance from the populated area. As we have discussed, the coal or thermal power plant or steam power plant has lots of problems related to pollution, flue gases, ash, and fumes, smoke. So these are the things. If you will be keeping the factors under consideration, how much pollution is being caused by the steam power station, obviously it should be avoided for the populated area. So the distance from populated area should be considered, as the huge amount of coal is burnt into the steam power station. Therefore, smoke and fumes pollute the surrounding area. This is the major concern, and this necessitates that the plant should be located at a considerable distance from the populated area. We cannot install a steam power plant at a densely populated area, right? So this is a very important thing. And at last we come to the conclusion. I was discussing about the last in the last class that the people who are residing nearby the Korba or Shahdol in Madhya Pradesh, which is having the thermal power plants in their vicinity, the problem comes into the ppm level of the CO2, the ppm level of the fresh air. The fresh air contains so many particles are there. So parts per million pollution is much higher as compared to the other cities. And I was telling you that the precipitation of the burning of coal, and their precipitation can be seen in the groundwater also, the running water also. And people who are living nearby areas are very prone to the asthmatic problems also. So these are the drawbacks of thermal power stations which need to be considered also when selecting the sites. So conclusion is that it is clear from the all above factor that it cannot be favorable at one place. However, keeping in view that the fact that nowadays supply system is AC and most important is being given to the generation, then transmission, a site away from the town may be selected so that transmission could be there, so that people could be less affected by the pollution. And at particular site by riverside where sufficient water is available, no pollution of atmosphere occurs and fuel can be transported economically, may perhaps be an ideal choice because we need lot of groundwater. So the riverside is suitable because in the riverside mostly cities are away from the nearby river sites. Most of the cities are installed near the banks of India also, but those were the old cities, and the new area which needs to be placed steam power plants, so that the choice could be reversing, right? So lots of pollution could not be there because riverside area is having lots of vegetation is there, lots of plantation is there by the riverside, so it could be possible that the pollution occurs less there, or the effects of pollution got less. So this is all about the choice of site selection or site of location for steam power station. These six factors needs to be considered.